I would like to mention a very important point, a very important matter. I want you all to pay attention. I don't mind if people go against me, if they attack me, I don't mind, because I am going to talk about a person who has insulted the most beloved of Allah, for whom Allah created the whole universe, that is Muhammadur Rasulullah.
When Jibreel first came, alayhi salam, when Jibreel first came, even the messenger had to accept Islam. Like, you know when you say somebody converted to Islam, somebody reverted to Islam, somebody took Shahada? Well, the messenger والسلام, also had to, in a sense, become Muslim when the angel came. And that moment was a big moment. When the angel came, he has no idea what's going on. He has no clue what this is yet. When he's being shaken and he's being told, Iqra, read, he has no idea what's going on.
About whom Allah Ta'ala stated in the Holy Quran, Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadira. Oh Habib, we have sent you, Allah says, we have sent you as witness. Allah says, oh my Habib, Tabarak alladhi nazzal al-furqan ala abdihi liyakuna lil'alamin nadira. We have sent you as a Rasul, as a warner for the entire creation. Allah says, oh my Habib, wama arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil'alamin. We have sent you as rahmat, as mercy for the entire creation of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala says, oh my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no one should call you with a term which are being misused, misquoted by the enemies. For example, some people, when Sahaba used to say, Ra'ina ya Rasulullah, when there was a matter, when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised something, when Sahaba could not understand properly, they used to say, Ra'ina ya Rasulullah, and they meant, ya Rasulullah, could you please repeat it again? We could not understand, but the enemy started dragging this word Ra'ina to Ra'ina, which gave a different meaning. Allah states in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, O believers, La taqulu Ra'ina, don't call Ra'ina to my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because some people are dragging this word Ra'ina and giving a wrong meaning. Do not use any such term which can be misquoted by the enemies. Then Ya Allah, what to call? Allah says, وَقُولُوا أُنظُرْنَا. You say, أُنظُرْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Look upon us with mercy, Ya Rasulullah. This is the adab taught by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Further, Allah Ta'ala states in the Holy Quran, Ya أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَن تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. O believers, do not raise your voices on the voice of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not talk to each other. Do not talk to Prophet the way you talk to each other. You talk in friendly manner with each other, but do not talk in such a manner in front of my Habib sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you do so, you may think that you have 10 Hajj in your account. You may think if you have 50 Umrah in your account. You are offering prayer for last 50 years. You are observing fast for last 50 years. Allah says, "Antahbata a'malukum." All your good deeds will be destroyed, will be vanished, nothing will remain. You may be unaware of it. You may be thinking, I have so much of rewards in my account. Allah says, just for the sake of the disrespect towards my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking loudly in front of my Habib, all your good deeds will be vanished, nothing will remain in your account. That is the Habib about whom Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala states, May yuti'ir Rasul, faqad ata'a Allah. The one who obeys Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed he has obeyed Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He is that Rasul about whom Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala states, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ. Allah Ta'ala states towards the ruh, the souls of the prophets of Allah, مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Allah took a covenant from the prophets of Allah before they were sent to this world. That is from the souls of the prophets of Allah. Allah uses the term نَبِيِّينَ. That means they were the prophets of Allah even in عالم الأرواح. Allah says, oh the jamaat of the prophets, when my Rasul comes towards you during your period, لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ. You should definitely believe upon my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّ. You should definitely completely support my Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, Allah knows that He is going to send His Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after Hazrat Isa alayhi sallam. Then why is Allah asking such a question, saying, oh, the Jamaat of the Prophet, if my Habib comes towards you during your period, you should believe in him, you should support him. Allah wanted to mention here that, oh, the Jamaat of the Anbiya, I have given you the Prophethood because of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the wasila for your Prophethood. I have elevated your status for my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah has used the term Nabiyyin for all the Prophets of Allah, ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ, Allah didn't say, I will appoint a Rasul later on who will come. No, when my Rasul comes to you. So when Allah has mentioned the term Nabi and Rasul for His Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and for all the Prophets of Allah, who the hell is Muhammad Ali Khan or any other Wahhabi who had said today, their clips are available in YouTube, saying when Jibreel alayhi salam came, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted Islam when Jibreel alayhi salam brought the message. So was our Nabi a kafir before? Oh, Nouman Ali Khan, who gave you such authority to utter such a statement about Allah's Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about whom Allah has stated Rasul before He sent His Rasul to this world. And all those listening to the lectures of Nouman Ali Khan, or all such Wahhabis who are linked with Nouman Ali Khan, such as Dr. Zakir Naik, Mufti Ismail Mink, or Dr. Bilal Philip, or any other scholars, beware, my dear brothers and sisters. We are not here to criticize any person in person here. We tell about them because they insulted Allah's Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.